great uprising, free people. People of the West Indies, and the people of so-called Jamaica, specifically, we are in trouble. Here is an image of the Prime Minister of Jamaica. And remember, the government of Jamaica, a irresponsible government. The government of Jamaica is a what we would know as a crown agency. Yeah, occupying colonial crown agency. That's the government of Jamaica. That's the business area. This is where Andrew Oldness is responsible for. Right now, we can all place a vote of no confidence. Have Parliament remove this government by default, put in the next government and give them a try. And after you remove this government, you start arresting all of these people who are criminals in office. Remove that imaginary immunity that I'm cling to. That way, as an example, whichever other government that they're in, and will know for conduct themselves accordingly. Here is the Prime Minister in Israel, where these people purport themselves to be Jews, but they always say they're Jewish and Israeli, yes. But these people were convert to that religion, and I think it was sometime in the 8th century, these people convert to that religion, so at no point they can be the original people. They just call themselves Israel, just like how they usurped the Hebrew language, it not belong to them. They usurped that. This is why they offer add all different kind of things to what they bring forward. And again, just their own basic research out here. Now, we talk about the British. The British government, the British nationality act, the British. Yes. Because the British is the one that gave these people land over there in what I'm called Judah and Syria. Come on. The British did that. And what most people miss is when me always I say we are British subjects. People miss it because they don't realize that the moment you claim to be a British subject, which naturally you are, you can't get away from it. It's their paperwork. You understand? And we know we are outwork Indian because we make our own declaration. But for the people, when I comprehend, you know, what is being shared, when we say you're a British subject, that means that you fix up your document as such and you don't need no visa for travel anymore. No different from the American national. This is why I am stressed these things, and it may have nothing to do with Windrush. It has everything to do with what I'm called the constitutional law. And this is why I say the government of Jamaica, this agency, is in a rush to extricate themselves from the responsibility. The judicial head is in the Privy Council and can't get away from that. The statutory instrument was created, giving them legislative powers. That's it. For my call, final legal standard. So when we see this man, who yesterday was in bed with China, properly in bed with China, properly in bed with Bill Gates. This guy only associates himself with the elite that seems to be godless, tyrant. Yeah, Israel is an apartheid state. And this is why I am here. I make my stance. I said, well, I was free. And this is why this government after me. Well, when I want to say it's just the government, now I say this Labour Party government. which is an apartheid government. Even when you had them friend them, you know, chew you up and spit you out, same way. Them all cater for the elite, and not necessarily the rich here, the elite. These kind of people, these kind of foreign people, that's our island. We won't get to see these people. And then the moving of our circle. You understand? These are the people that is spoken about in the Bible, say, hey, you who claim to be Jews but are not. You are the synagogue of Satan, and you're a liar, just like your father, the devil, is a liar. And here is our prime minister in bed with the synagogue of Satan. So why are we surprised when the old pirate Henry Morgan is consist of criminals? There is no way you without integrity. And when we say you and your wife is a business partner, so go for both of you. Your wife have no standing, sitting on that seat. It's illegitimate. You're a speaker of the house. You guys are playing one of those games where there's only a few who can actually see. We are being oppressed by an occupying colonial crown agency. And at present, the Jamaica Labour Party is a government that is making a mess. Number one, I hear the Prime Minister talk about protecting the brown Jamaica. Prime Minister, we don't have a viable railway system, and we should have that on the island. And that would alleviate a lot of the problem we have on the roadways. Viable railway system will run at certain time where people can always know, say, watch out. If you can't catch the train and go up in our country or go which part, you know what I mean? We need that on the island. Our island is too developed for we don't have that kind of infrastructure. We don't have our own airline. There's no airline here, say Air Jamaica. We don't own practically none of the businesses then that is probably that's a next to Fortune 500 business. We don't own. It's all foreign investors here. And all you will do is just take your cut, fat up your bank, and you don't care about the rest. So this is why I say I do not wish to be led or governed by these kind of people. I'm not interested. This is why I take the step to renounce it, to cancel, and to say I'm not interested. Yeah, man. And there is no one on earth that's doing what I'm doing, and I don't understand why. Everybody want to play a game with the foreign Congress. I say, you have a King Kong want to be African, this dude want to be African. You know what I mean? Talk a lot of mess because he's a psychologist. So no fear was in wit amongst lower thinking people. You understand? And this is how the scammers work, but I guarantee this one to the African will be the another brother polite we hear about out here. He'll be the next brother polite we hear about out here. Because you professing to be African, hey, you African and blah, 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 blah. Not realizing your documentation, say America. Your colonial accreditation say you are American. Your birth location, your stepmom, you're probably another good here, but I mean, yet you profess to be African. This is why I'm known as proper agents. If you're an African and you love Africa so much, and you don't want to go there and advocate from there, then you're an imposter. But for all Pan-Africans, because I'm looking at the African people that's challenging the French government, the French power, and they're doing well. Their voices are loud. And none of you flunkies from the mainland with your PhD will not challenge the foreign Congress They never challenge that big elephant that is enslaving you. You can't see yourself as a slave. This is why you escape and say, "Hey, I'm African," when you know you can never be an African. Impossible. Impossible. This is the deception. This is the distraction. This is what is really going on. Get carried away with psychologists, with their psychology. Yeah, carried away. And as I said, it's only the lesser intellectual folks. These guys can sway. They can come in front, an independent thinker, and speak. As they open your mouth and say, "I am African," I'll say, "Prove it. Show me an ancestral lineage that say you are African. You might have been Muslim with the Abdullah name inside of your bloodline. But demonstrate that you're African. And if you're African, then you'll be African." You can't tell everybody say, "I'm an African dumb boy with a PhD. This monkey looking, gorilla looking, King Kong looking, joker." It's hard for me to give them a certain kind of respect when they can look right through narcissism and some, toy soldiers. You've done nothing, just make no stand outside of in the university, the local university. That's the only place you guys make stand, debating. You know nothing about outside, absolutely nothing about the street. You weren't brought up that way. But when you get your PhD or your doctorate or any kind of colonial degree, which is a privileged pass. So when you say I have a platform now, your platform must start like, oh, probably mine start one subscriber, two, three subscriber, then it's a 15. No. You guys, it has come out. And within 3 days, you have 20,000 views. Within the next 3 days, you have another 50,000 views. That's how you're set up. And this is how we know you people are agents, proper agents. You never advocate for your own freedom. You talk Africa, Africa, Africa all day. Right now, Africans are liberating themselves openly, publicly. Yet, they're looking at the Americans like, what's wrong with those people? Can't they see it's foreigners that is colonizing them to this day? It's still extant. You can't say that. Now them will look outside. So them will critique everyone, everybody else, and everybody else is dumb because they didn't go in a university to get any kind of degree or accreditation. So you're dumb. And they are brilliant, yet they can't see the chain that is attached to their neck. They can't see it. They never open their mouth to the colonizers occupying their area. Why is that? Because people like this want to be African. He's totally unaware of his origin. Most come out of, again, plantation. Most, as I said, in history, we're not far down that road. So for my people on the mainland, until you people choose to rise up against your foreign oppressors, your foreign colonizers, then you'll always be the brunt of everybody's joke. This is why they removed the West Indian term. Are we separate and distinct as an island people? And we as an island people permeate the mainland. We've always traversing, traveling back and forth. And just like how we have children on the mainland, you have several, you have a plethora of island people appearing over there. Same way. But our origin is a little bit different. And when we look in our location, we see majority of us. And the ruling power is always the foreigners, always not looking like the original people. Pretty soon, if we're not aware, when it's at Jamaica, we will be hearing them, but you'll see images of that's foreign looking people. Now we have a prime minister that is in bed with an apartheid regime, an apartheid nation, an apartheid state. This state that is mentioned in the Bible as, though you say you are Jews, you are not. Yeah, man, you're a synagogue of Satan, man. You're a liar, just like your father, the devil is a liar. And I may say, the Bible, I say, that's why you want to like the Bible. And when we pick and choose what we want, we can bring the Bible and say, then you can draw for any book we want. But the question is this, if these guys convert to Judaism in the 18th, in the 8th century, so, when Christ, who would I say was a Jew, Christ and this guy would not be affiliated. It would be impossible. And remember, these are the same Ashkenazi people, Khazars, or Khuzars to be proper. These are the people from the Black Sea area and beyond. These are the very same people. Remember, Iran, Persia. Even the Bible tells about the prince of Persia that was demonic. So when I said I'm at war over this and nature, the Christian, the Muslims, and the Jews are always at it. Yet them said that is the Holy Land. And there is no peace in that land over there, which is supposed to be holy. Why is that? Because there's imposters occupying those locations. Yeah, man, Judah, Palestine didn't exist. It was just like, well, no one get ahead of myself. But we know Judah, the writer, and we know Syria was the empire where it took over all of these places before it broke out. And all of these people have their own ideological view of this. You know, earth. They have their own policy, they have their own religion, they have their own thing. But them are the one them that create the money. Remember, you know, Lucifer, them that govern these places. These are the money changers. Rothschild, you, these people infiltrate every facet of governmental organization and corrupt it with money. This is why we have a prime minister that is right now wealthy beyond his wildest dreams. And if you give him a forensic audit, you'll have to lift up a prison, dig a hole, put him inside it, bury him in that hole, and then put the prison on top of him. And that goes for his wife. Yeah, criminal to the core, but when you have a criminal organization, a criminal conspiracy, then they seem unperturbed. It's under the most like, can really come forward and, you know, shine light on their activities. Yeah, you won't be able to touch them. Because I'm on demonstration that when you're traveling on the road, whether driving or doing anything, if you're outside of commerce, these guys can't regulate you. They only can regulate commercial activity. Yet these guys are going over their scope and jurisdiction, over their bounds. These guys are purporting themselves to the God. Now I can say, why is that? Because you're aligning yourself with an apartheid state. You're going to bring the same police state that Israel imposed on the Palestinian over there. You're going to try that here in Jamaica. I'm not sure if that is going to work. I'm not sure if that is going to work. You know, you're not going to take all of the rights and would assist you. It will never happen. I'm telling you already. Look at how the place is now. If the head is corrupt, filthy, and criminal, then don't be surprised when the whole populace is like that. Corrupt, filthy, and criminal. The whole populace is like that. A few good people when they get involved in the criminality are just not a few. When you look at the machinery, the governmental machinery, or the political machinery.
everybody is cotton.
Well, most people are compromised. Yes, if not all, they are compromised. And all of them get compromised sleeping with little boys, I don't understand. And these little boys grow up to be big men, and some of them head chips, and I'm just spill everything. Else we wouldn't know what's going on. We have an incompetent governance, an incompetent government, and an incompetent, it has said, legislative body. Set a boot of people. And them said they don't want to lead and go.
It's a shame.
It is a shame. Look at this guy. Well proud. When this Israeli bastard get charged by the international community for war crimes, you shall be implicated in that. And next thing, you have this wannabe African in America advocating, hey, Africa, Africa. And for whatever reason, this guy don't realize that, hey, Congress take all kind of money and give to Ukraine to fight Ukraine's war. Why is that? How America get involved in that? Politics. And then them come again and give a whole ton of money to Israel to fight for. Yet, you look at the populace in that nation. You see how much people are suffering around it. Specifically, those black people that is the original people of that location. And when you have imposters, sellout agents like those gorilla looking, ugly looking, doctor looking sissies out there, distracting you, talking about Africa. Africa don't need our help anymore. Africa is doing excellent. Africa is doing what the Americans can never get the balls to do. It's only Malcolm X tribe. Only Malcolm X tribe. And the very same people, that's right here, you people. You're the ones that take him out. You're the very same one that take him out and put up a puppet. Louis Farrakhan. And won't accomplish. Man. One of my people could just say, then, you know, a lot of things would change easily. If only we could just say, there is love, constitutional law is love. We don't need no visa to travel to the mainland America. But if you're a slave and you don't know who you are, then you're going to require a visa. Yeah, man, salute to my firstborn. American national, step by step out again. This is what we are talking about. And the very same information we share at it once they use and upgrade another thing. So when I get carried away with you guys over there that is totally unaware of enslavement, playing all kind of sissy games with that foreign Congress, totally unaware. You have an old guy that is about 194 years old, is a president. That guy can't walk, can't talk, can't see. I must have put a battery inside that guy. And you people, yeah, it's just sad. Wait, it's time for you, you know, wake. You can't even wake up, just wake. Silly. I'm African. And all the documentation say you're American. And where are you located? Right here in America. You guys are scammers. Proper scammers. But hey, you get a license to scam. So you're legal. And again, it's only the lesser IQ with gravitate. Where you go.
Someone like me, me only want to see the image of where you're saying that. So you can't listen to people. Different frequency. Yeah. And a slave can't talk to me. No glorified slave. But people pay attention, we are in trouble. This man is an, you know, evil man. And him have an evil country called Israel, where full of military equipment. This is why our prime minister body up, him want more technology, more weaponry, more a police state.
Salute to the Jamaica Defense Force. I hear people say, Andrew control the defense. Andrew no control, no defense. The defense is moving from out of the governor general's office. Andrew can only advise. Andrew control the police. Andrew no control the military. But after too much military work, the man they not playing. And the man they no life. And the man they no truth. So anytime it comes down to it, we guarantee you to have at least 3/4 of the military that stand against the Luciferian force. And that's not against it. And that's the military. The police probably is a third. And most of them, again, are employed for escape poverty. So, you know, they put them on 2-3 mission and things, let them have their own personal guns to keep on here and things, then they do all kinds of things for these politicians. But pay attention, politicians create wars. None of these guys are put it. And now kit up, strap up, and go to the fight. These guys will never do that. But they'll send your children out there to die for them. And they won't even blink an eye for you. Wise up out there, people. Really. We are being oppressed. We have an occupying colonial crown agency known as a government of Jamaica that is an oppressive organization, oppressive agency. It is the one that's in power. And if they take a vote now, 90% of Jamaica, I would say, boy, we don't have no confidence. You want to highlight industries, not what we own. You want to highlight the brand where some other people own. And come and then buy out this and call it Jamaica. And they say, oh, support it, but a foreign benefit? Absolutely not, not from the us other people. This is why we have what is called ghetto. And the ghetto was created from you politicians. And you never fix up the ghetto. You never create gainful employment for the people in the ghetto. So when everybody degenerate to a place or a state now where it's just street criminality, now everybody has a problem. But this is a real problem. It's from the leadership. Start from the head, start from the top. And if we have an organization like the Jamaica Labour Party, which is a criminal created organization, the man that created the Jamaica Labour Party was in prison, and the colonial imperialists take him out of prison to create the Jamaica Labour Party to go up against the People's National Party, which was a liberating party for the people who go up against the imperialists, against the colonists, against these foreign devils. The Jamaica Labour Party, criminal organization, counter that, never for the people, anti-people, always. This was the very party that, you know, CIA claimed burned down Eventide home with how many people, over 100 odd people. These guys have never bought an eye. And nobody got prosecuted, nothing come out of these. We're in trouble. But, you know, truth always manifests itself and bring glory. Yeah, to the beholder, you know. Truth always. Anyway, I am born for them imposter there. I am born for the little dance them about there. I am born for one of them. Talk it up on them people. Imposters. Oh yeah, African. African way.
You're scared of the enslaver Congress that's in your location. So they bypass everything else and claim African. You're an agent. Yeah, man. and you're a wealthy agent, kind of rich. Yeah, but it's not impressive. I notice how hard enough out there every day I talk a lot of this with a psychology degree. Psyching all the people and I a bum. This criminal in office, look at them. Even Mark Golden probably is a joke. I know him now put up fame Joe hot on him. Now put fame like him up in oil palette. The thing for him, I'm not going to put it down right now. Prime sister, the Joe, them are going too bad out there. But Mark Golden always look like a little Jewish man to me. Anyway, it's neither here nor there. Let's shoot rain out there. Let's shoot rain. Clap it up on them. Burn them. Those fools.